Nor do the military have answers. They haven't been able to resolve the mystery of UFOs seen over Europe in the last months of World War II by US night fighter crews, who dubbed them Foo Fighters.
The sightings we saw were, I think, were in about in the 44, and November or December then, we'd see these balls of light that would fly off the wings of our airplane. The one I saw was like a white light. A lot of the other people reporting in it saw old red lights, and some of them would see some green lights, and some of them reported that they would try to chase one, why they couldn't, they never could catch it.
We'd turn into it, and it would turn with us. And we'd turn away from it, and it would still turn with us. And I put my gun sights on, trying to get on it, but I never could.
We flew the British Mosquito, which was capable of 450 knots, and we opened it up a number of times and tried to close with it, and we never came anywhere close to it.
German secret weapon, false images in pilots' eyes, natural phenomena. Investigations drew a blank.
I think the book is open on whether it was imagination, hallucination, or really extraterrestrial or German ground control object, but I haven't seen anything in 50 years that changed the perception of what they were other than unidentified flying.
Life in post-war America appears tranquil. But national security is still at stake. Is the US under Soviet aerial surveillance? Could Big Brother be watching? UFO sightings are most disturbing near sensitive sites. Atomic secrets are at risk. The threat of nuclear war raises the stakes. Soviet agents and communist subversives could be anywhere. Anyone may be an alien. They look like us.
Say, could you tell me what... Yes, comrade. Nothing. Nothing, never mind.
UFO reports and rare... UFO reports and rare witnesses' films do not go to the police or scientists. For 22 years, they're collected for Air Force investigation, always with the two aims described by Project Blue Book's first head.
First of all, to try to determine if the UFO phenomena presents a threat to the security of the United States. And second, to determine if the UFO phenomena exhibits any technological advances which could be channeled into research and development.
In 1969, the files are closed. The Air Force conclusion, no threat and poor data.
They looked at 3,201 sightings. They categorized every single one. They did a quality evaluation of every single one. And what they found was 21% of the 3,201 cases that they examined had to be listed as unknowns, completely separate and distinct from the 10% that were listed as insufficient information. They found that the better the quality of the sighting, the more likely to be an unknown. And yet, what did the Secretary of the Air Force say to the public? He said, on the basis of this report, we believe that no objects such as those popularly described as flying saucers have overflown the United States.
Believers wait for signs. Skeptics want the ultimate proof. At last it comes.
I was absolutely thrilled. To me, this was one of the great moments in my research.
The leaked papers British researcher Tim Good received in 1987 seem the answer. The above top secret documents concern US government contacts with aliens. Those in charge are named the Majestic 12. The papers are for President-elect Eisenhower. They reveal the recovery of aliens in New Mexico in 1947. A flying saucer crashes. A local rancher reports finding it 75 miles northwest of Roswell Army Airfield. The wreckage is unrecognizable. No wires or conventional parts. During the recovery, four dead aliens are found. News of the crash gets out. The remains are removed to several different locations for analysis. An effective cover story given out. Civilian witnesses are debriefed.
There was no question that the importance of these documents was monumental. I mean, nothing like it before had surfaced.
It's dynamite. Proves there are flying saucers, alien visitors, the whole business. The implication is, one, Earth is being visited by extraterrestrial spacecraft. Two, the government has known not only that that is true in the abstract.
No question that the Majestic 12 papers have indeed pointed people in the right direction. And I think, essentially, the information contained therein is accurate.
To get a good view of government UFO files, one group goes to court. The National Security Agency protests in an affidavit. The judge refuses to let them read the contents.
We file for the 21-page above top secret affidavit. The judge had referenced it in his finding, and we eventually got it. The only trouble is, as you start to go through it, you find that it's blacked out, and pretty soon all blacked out. 75% of the document isn't there, and people say, scrape away the black, there's nothing underneath. They Xerox it first.
In the eyes of the state, there is no need to know why there is no need to know.
The cover-up alone is proven by the released documents, released by agencies such as the FBI, who denied any involvement in UFO research until the Freedom of Information Act showed that they'd been lying. They released 1,100 pages of documents. CIA denied any interest in the subject. Suddenly, we have now, I would think, thousands of pages of UFO-related information dating back to the 1940s, which quite clearly indicates that there has been a cover-up.
100,000 cases are archived at the Private Center for UFO Studies. Mainstream science ignores them.
I am convinced by over 20 years of work in this field that there is a mysterious phenomenon.
The former Soviet Union, March 1990. Interceptors scramble to investigate pulsing lights northeast of Moscow. For 3.5 hours, they stalk the UFO, which moves at speeds up to 3,000 miles an hour. No radar image appears on the screens of ground stations. Thermal imaging produces results. The UFO is photographed. The secret results are proof for the Chief of Air Defense. His pilots do not fire on UFOs.
He only used radar and not armaments against UFOs.
Nor are personnel seeing Western stealth planes.
We never thought it was American stealth aircraft. The radar characteristics are not the same. Stealth behaves like a plane in terms of speed and maneuverability. UFOs are very different.
Their files list many cases. This pilot finds a light closing on him. there's contact. The aircraft goes into a rapid descent. On landing, there's damage to the left wing. From 1977 on, an official Ministry of Defense study collects hundreds of reports. They hope to gain alien technology for military use. The covert research continues. Is this a UFO or smoke from a gunnery exercise? Mass observation of UFOs is nothing new in the East. Is this UFO a balloon? At dawn the next morning, local militia video this nearby. Enhanced, the night visitor looks like this. Hundreds of people see a giant UFO over the city of Petrozavodsk in northwest Soviet Academy of Sciences. Such phenomena are considered worthy of serious inquiry. In addition to the country's military study, the governing body for academic research coordinates the countrywide collection of information for scientific analysis. The building houses the Central Committee for the Study of UFOs, which gathers data from 10 other scientific academies.
We carry out research in two ways. One is passive. We analyze UFO reports. The other way is active. For some sightings, we carry out investigations in the field.
Twelve years of research are carried out at this site. Train passengers see a UFO approach. They say a metallic craft landed here. Biologist Professor Simiakov believes there are permanent changes to the scene.
This is the landing place where we carried out some interesting tests. We did experiments in both physics and biology.
His experiments find living creatures shun these spots. Divining rods find unusual spiral energy patterns at UFO landing sites. 20 years of studies produce similar results. From the early days on, the ground inside is empty of all life, even microbes. According to his measurements, inside the circles, time speeds up. Most puzzling of all, Earth samples taken from landing sites contain tiny spheres. His work leads him to conclude these are extraterrestrial, containing DNA, the seed of life itself. Tests in America are divided, either of unknown origin.